celebration. First, I want to express my gratitude to Spring Hill Presbyterian Church for generously allowing us to use their facilities for this momentum occasion and for consistently partnering with our school. We do appreciate it. Thank you, Mr. Buddy. Next, I would like to take a moment to thank our parents, grandparents, teachers, staff, and other family members who help the students to where they are today. So parents and families, thank you for the love, encouragement, and support you have given your children during their elementary years. So parents of fifth graders, please stand. So we can recognize you and all of your efforts. We could not make it without you. So students, let's give your parents a round of applause for being here. We definitely could not make it without your support at Austin, and we appreciate the partnership and you supporting your students and our teachers each and every day. To the teachers who have impacted the fifth grade students' lives throughout their years at Austin, thank you for your expertise, energy, and devotion to the students' learning and development. At every grade level, students at Austin Elementary are nurtured and valued by our fantastic teachers and staff. A special thanks to our fifth grade teachers who have guided this class forward through this year and ensured much growth academically and socially. We know that this group is ready to transition and to move on to middle school. Now, I would like to address our fifth grade students. I am honored to share some of my thoughts with you as we reflect on your journey at Mary Austin. This fifth grade group is very special to me. I have to get myself together on this one. This is my very first group that I have watched through kindergarten all the way through fifth grade. I have watched them grow since their kindergarten year. They have grown up, worked hard, made friends, and accomplished much, and have been taught by many wonderful teachers. So today I would like to recognize and celebrate all of your accomplishments. Students, you have learned how to read and write. You have become proficient at math, learned how to think like entrepreneurs, and used your talents to create solutions to real-world problems that were showcased during Shark Tank and other technology projects. Your social studies and science lessons have familiarized you with many of the world's regions, customs, historical events, and scientific methods. You have created beautiful pieces of art, designed presentations, and learned much about physical fitness and wellness. Also, you have shown kindness by helping others and giving back to your community. Most importantly, each of you stepped into your fifth grade role in your own way and made a unique contribution to our school. You have challenged and supported each other, had some great laughs and fun times, made mistakes, and learned from them, and developed a hearty self-esteem by earning it through hard work and perseverance. Students, I would like to challenge you as you transition to middle school. Work hard, stay focused, and see your dreams through. And I want to share a poem that was written by a 12-year-old. Her name was Gritty Jordan. The poem is Never Give Up. If I made mistakes, then I would have to retake and do it once again, even feel the pain. But there also lies a prize ahead, and that made me realize that even if I was to fail, it would be a learning trail. If I hope for medals and a cup, I can't just rely on luck. I must work hard to show the world my worth. That's the essence of never giving up. And so students, most of you know, if you've ever been to my office, or if we had a talk in the hallway, I always tell you that I know you make mistakes, and mistakes are okay because you're learning. That's what growing up is all about. But if you keep doing it over and over again, it becomes a choice. So I also tell you when you fall down, get back up, and the sign on the wall says, never, ever, ever give up on your dreams and anything that you would like to do in life. And I know I've had that conversation with many of you. And so, and now to all of you, never ever give up. No matter what obstacles, no matter what challenges come your way, you can do it. So in closing, as fifth graders, you've learned a lot at Mary Austin, However, you have much more to learn ahead. Be willing to keep on learning from your teachers, coaches, parents, and friends. Keep a positive attitude, a helpful spirit, and put your best effort in all you do. Don't forget to keep up good habits, such as reading, cleaning your rooms, your parents are going to love that one, being kind to others, and always wear a smile. I love you all so much, and I wish you nothing but the best for your future. Congratulations, to the great students.
At this time, we are entering the awards portions of our Honors Day. We have several awards we'll be handing out to some very deserving students. Students, if your name is called, please come join us on the stage.
Thank you.
award is presented to Tommy Shutter.
Sebastian Slick. Tommy Shutter.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Michael, for an upset.
First up, we have Ashton Amanda.
My last and final challenge to you. In a world where you can be anything, be kind. And to show your kindness, there are many ways. So stop waiting for opportunities to be kind to someone today. You can donate money, you can volunteer, do whatever you can to bring about a cheer. You may think of it small and insignificant, but in someone's life, it could be a life-changing fact. And I also hope that Ruth's motto is forever in your heart. So for the very last time as fifth graders, let's say it together.
Respect ourselves and others, all our learning, all our actions, treasure our talents, serve our community. These are the roots of success.
Thank you.